Hello, folks, and welcome back to Warhammer 40K Space Marine. Let's go purge some heretics. Part 5, Prince of Demons. I always thought it was Daemons, but they're saying demons here. My aunt pronounced it that way. There was some program she had, Daemon Tools? That's how she said it, and yeah, just took it from there. Well, demons, daemons, whatever. They get the bolter.
I must reach the orbital spire.
Farewell, Captain.
So here, Prince Daemons. I'm just doing it unwittingly. Not that, not henflesh. Man against demon. Prince of Daemons. Found to the right. Okay, after we exit the elevator. Found to the right of it. Right here.
It is a noble and worthy thing.
Stench of aliens permeates this facility, but it is tolerable because it represents progress. I acquired specimens for experimentation. Org, Tau, Eldar. Even a Tyranid Lictor, which nearly caused a revolt among my tech priest allies. I designed the weapon to use the warp energies to target the weak points in the Xenos brain and rupture them. That is the tidy theory. When I put it into practice, however, the specimen's head explodes. Distasteful, but effective. The weapon works.
All right. Tyranid Victor. Don't Tyranids have that Shadow in the Warp thing? It must be just in bigger numbers or when the Hive Fleet is nearby, but yeah, Gene Stealers don't have it. Okay, it's before we head outside and destroy the pipe after a renegade fight. Should be naming videos that, you know, saying that, oh yes, I found a skull on this one and a skull on this one, like I did with Halo. Even though I started this before Halo and long before, I'm releasing it after. But I don't know. I've already named all the videos up to this point, up to before last set. So I know, it just feels like, you know what? We'll leave it as it is. What am I doing? Could you crouch? You know, that was unnecessary, right? I've seen you teleport in here, you know, without doing that before. Whoa, you're a dick.
Yeah.
some to play aggressive and kill them off before they could do, you know, summon anyone, but no, that was not an option. Okay, I doubt we can... Ow. Yeah, I doubt we can do the kills on them. Oh, I forgot grenades. It's Q as far as I remember. Great. Ooh, I got a last cannon. Nice. Stop dancing! Fucking safety dance. Seriously, that's noxious. I do wish I was a bigger fan of 40K, like I was more into it, because I feel like I would really enjoy, you know, appreciate this game more. You know? Like, it's a fine game in its own right, but I feel a fan of the series would really appreciate it. No, you die. Beautiful. I think I had the audio balance kind of poor in my earlier videos on this series. Do apologize.
Fresh troops are landing, preparing to assault the orbital spire.
It may be severed, but it's still the enemy's strong point.
The fleet is preparing an all-out assault.
Their attack will not be enough to stop the forces of chaos.
I know. Good luck, Titus.
Okay, let me just check my phone. Ah, the next section is called Traitor's Arena. And it is inside. Okay, everyone's ready. I love this gun. Oh, I just fucked myself. Oh. It's gonna be one hell of a smut fic. I know. Captain Titus here is about to get spit roasted two different ways at once. Their dick and their demon dicks will meet in the center. I mean, ooh, actually no, these aren't Slaneshi, but still, it'll happen. I've seen the fanfics. For once, I lie. How many dicks does it take to get to the center of a space, to the center of a space marine? Let's find out. They just need to put more handrails all over the place. The demons don't know how to respond to them. Corrin has no concept of safety. What are these strange things? I cannot comprehend them. Yeah, that was inevitable. It's nice of them to leave all these supplies just available for me, and not, you know, yoink them for themselves. You know? Because I'm sure, like, the Chaos Marines could do with some extra... they could do it with some extra ammo and shit. So... for a moment I was thinking, you know, where are the orcs? But the orcs are done. For anyone who knows less about the 40k lore than me, you may be puzzled why an Inquisitor was fucking with warp powers. There's two types of Inquisitor. Like the Inquisitor you would expect, and then a radical Inquisitor. That's the term. Radical. Totally radical, dude. Totally. The radical Inquisitors, I don't know where the guys are gone. They'll try and use the powers of the warp. You know, they're much more loose with, you know, restrictions. At least on themselves. Obviously, they are beyond Chaos Tank, but everyone else, oh no, we'll murder you just for seeing them. In one of them, the guy had an outright, like, demon bound into one of his, you know, followers. It was actually kind of a tragic thing. From memories, like, people were saying, but, like... Sorry, can I get by? Thank you. Like, the guy was betrayed and had the demon soul bound into him by what he believed was his friends, I think? That was within one of the novels? I was reading this off a wiki yonks back. I might be misremembering. But, yeah, so yeah, you may imagine Inquisitors one way, but no, they fuck with war powers as well. Well, it depends on the group of them. There's radical and then there's not. Orthodox, maybe? But yeah, the radical ones still fuck with war powers till the cows come home. Just you don't. And good, it is actually recording. It's a little loud, but you can hear me fine over it. The audio bars are actually correctly representative on this. So you can hear me, you can hear the game, you can see the game, and I'm indeed recording 52, 53, 54, 55. Move. Could you just fucking die? Finally. Mash. For robot girlyman. All right. Where do we have to look? Good. He just died. He didn't transform. Okay. I'm just looking at the architecture now. Might find the... Yeah, it's back here. Ran past it. I knew I heard it. But I heard it up the way.
Benjamin, we have to leave Epsilon Center. The orcs are coming. I'm so sorry, Ben. I can't leave you the next breadcrumb because I don't have a plan anymore. You've lost your mother.
So that's the end of their little chain. Ooh! Does not want me to read the guide for the next one. The last one. Come on, zoom out. Sorry, this is bugging. Zoom out. For whatever reason, it's now refusing to zoom out. There we go. Phone's freaking out right now. Reload the page. Yeah, for some reason it's just hyper fixed in. Now it's fine. Need weapons after you fought the bloodletter demons. Or are these bloodletters? Well, the ones I fought a moment ago, bottle actors? Huh. So they're blood thirsters. Whatever. Sup? Have an axe. Going back inside for the next one. So I don't have to worry about it till then. After playing Halo, they aren't quite as good as at those mooks for dodging grenades. Nice. Two shots, as long as one's ahead. With this, we'll even kill a Chaos Space Marine. Beautiful. These guys have a nasty guns. Well done. I think it was this game, they were like pointing out how it was weird that the head honcho of the invasion was like a sorcerer, and yet he's coronate demons with him. Because Khorne does not like sorcerers. You know? That was just another way. Alright. And so I cannot jump down. Starters, do not hurry. We take the long way around. Therefore, more mortals can die. Titus played too much FF8. And... he does want to end up start, you know, having lower seed rank. I would like to play FF8 at some stage, but I don't see it happening anytime soon. Need to find out video policy, and that's a pain in its own ass. And even if I was to find it out, I want to start at 1 and work my way up, and I don't know if I have access to... It's, yes, down at the far end of the corridor. I'm not sure what I would even play that on. And so it's just an all-around pain in the ass. It was wise of me to take this. They really clearly expect you to do so. They even leave it open for you to go back for it. Though you would take a hell of amount of damage trying to do so.
The warp device. Where is it?
Safe from you, demon.
Alright, that is the last one for this level. So we can relax and just get back to the sword. Firepower. Nice. True son of the Emperor. You know, the more I play this, the more sad I get it's not going to get a sequel, apparently. So. It's a shame. Because it is a good game. And like I said, I do wish I was a,
Marines, this is Captain Titus.
Captain Titus, Thunderhawk Lance of Jove is at your disposal.
I must reach the orbital spire. Tell your pilot to make his approach.
Yes, sir.
I wish I was more of a 40k fan. Like, I have some passing interest and whatnot in it, but I'm not a big fan of it. Like, not saying I dislike it, it's just that I'm not one of those people buying models and painting them, nor have I played tons of other 40k games, or even fantasy games. I have a passing interest in it. But yeah, I feel I'll love it even more. Okay, let me just check. In a hallway on the left, following the first encounter with the Chaos Psyker. Yeah, it's inside, so we don't have to worry about it for a bit. Damn, singing Blood Ravens.
Captain Titus, we joined the Liberation Fleet at Bakar, along with a squad of Black Templars.
Unleash the fury you showed in the Aurelian Crusade, and we will be glad to have even a few Blood Ravens with us.
You may rely on that, Captain.
Then join the forces driving into the Demon Host, and stop any enemies trying to follow me up the orbital spire.
None shall find us wanting.
Honor and glory, Blood Raven.
Remember the Aurelian Crusade thing I referenced earlier? They're in the previous set. Like, that's that's the reference, I guess. Remember, I was saying the wiki was saying that there's no specified date for when this game takes place. Just simply the Aurelian Crusade, which would have been Dawn of War 2. But apparently there's three of them or something. I don't know what they're talking about. Should have noted that.
The
Hopefully this concrete can stop the sci-fi grenades. Nice. Oh, that really overshot. Nice. Nice. Dodging. I don't know, I'm just playing reckless now. Dodgy. So would these be Black Legion Chaos Space Marines? I'm trying to judge by the armor, and I've got no idea. I don't know their iconography or their color schemes. I'm just guessing Black Legion has black armor. And they're not obviously like Skaneshi or Khorne. Or Nurgleites. Black Legion is Chaos Undivided. It's the only Chaos Undivided warband I know of. I'll probably get around to Dawn of War at some stage. No idea when though. I will be quite into doing that at some stage, playing it at some stage, but yeah, no idea when that will happen. Also want to do Mark of Chaos now that it's on GOG. Nice. Even if it did already pre-explode, because bullets. Ooh. Nice. San Francisco's certainly gone to pot. You know, the bridge?
Ground forces. Ultramarines drop pod incoming. What regular speaking had it. But now imminent. Ultramarines, deploy on my mark. Heavy infestation at drop point Validus. Cleanse and purge.
Ah, models. I think that was mine. Oh, they dropped behind enemy lines.
The job is worth doing. It's worth done.
Played a little too aggressive. Heresy grows from idleness. Yeah, I played a little too recklessly there, because I just kept fragging out of myself. I was like, fuck it. Fuck it.
Ground forces. Ultramarine drop pod incoming. Squad Regulus making planet fall. Touchdown imminent. Ultramarines, deploy on my mark. Heavy infestation at drop point Validus.
Oh, I can just fire through this. Okay, this is ridiculous. I think there's a guy inside me right now. Oh, didn't mean to tear it off. Now I don't have infinite ammo. Actually, I'll probably be bringing this with me anyway. Nice. We said earlier there was the last one or something. No, there's three more left. I was just when I was looking at the thing earlier, I ended up skipping a chapter. Okay. It's actually when you get in.
I will need all your skill, pilot.
We'll take you into the Eye of Terror if you ask it, Captain.
The orbital spire will do for today.
Beautiful.
I will hold here as long as I can, Captain.
No, brother. Rejoin our forces and bring fury to the enemy. This battle is mine alone.
Yes, sir.
Boom. Beautiful. Whoa. We get to execute these guys? I'm sorry, this is all I'm gonna be doing. Oh, that's so much fun. Oh no! Mortals! Whatever will I do?
This madness will not stop me, and neither will you.
Synchronized roaring, new Olympic sport. Nah, thought you'd already died. Can't be leaving one behind. Here we go. Beautiful.
I've encountered unexpected results. Warp energies affect different species in different ways. Essentially, I can tune this weapon to cause maximum damage to whatever enemy we face. Are caught in the blast wave, they will not be harmed. Good news, I suppose. I've not slept in 2 days. The more I use the warp device, the stronger the assault on my psychic shield. I need rest.
Sounds like it could be a very potent weapon, but... You know, if you think he'll be concerned about the constant onslaught. Okay, it's above us now on a chaos on a platform defended by a chaos space marine.
The dark gods.
Dark gods, what? That's because the sun was set. You know, a bit of cloud cover. Of course, shockwave so much it hit the guys that it shouldn't have. There it is. Very easy to miss here. Don't get to kill me! Only I get to kill me! A mind without purpose will wander in dark places. Devil makes work for idle hands. Wait, are they all dead? Seriously? Okay, that is kind of obnoxious. I wanted to do that fight again and do it right. Obnoxious.
Brothers thought the same, traitor. Their corpses lie behind them.
Die, heretics! So, just dropping on it. Thought I'd... Aww. So much fun. Thought I would drop by for a chat. Okay, where's the next one? The final one. Final one. Is... We'll fight a Chaos Drone, and then it's to the right, in a small room. I'm switching this out for the axe. Gonna do so anyway, but especially if we're gonna be going up against one of the other guys. Well, it's certainly nice of them to leave so much munitions and weapons around for me, you know? That's just games for you in general, but it's always funny. Damn Dark Mechanicum. Assuming they're the ones to make this. Flesh and metal, it's... Ugh. It's creepy. It's also leaking gas from where I've shot it. Warp fumes. Beautiful. Was he making a log when we initially met him? I can't remember, it's been far too long. Would've been fun if we had literally interrupted him just then. Maybe that's the implication. Demon host. Does it count if they're dead? It's a term if they're alive, but. Christ, they can frag out at a tremendous range. Let's leave the Iron Halo recharge. Ooh, that does not look healthy. Guys, we're back up on his feet for a bit more. You're just axing for trouble. Yep. Do it. Dramatic battle. Lasers flying, me just axing one guy. For a moment, I thought it was an orc. Yeah, it might be wise to turn about. Stop twitching. Eat it. Thank you for storing explosives, just conveniently. Ah. There's something I swore I remember hearing about, and it hasn't happened. Maybe it hasn't happened yet. Or maybe it was a fib. Or maybe I'm misremembering. I'll say it at the end if I remember.
Much blood in my hands, Nimrod, for all those you have killed, for Sidonus, and for the Emperor. I will finish this.
This does not look healthy. Oof. Man against demon.
I return I offer up this world and all those upon it. I ask. Ooh. For the reward that was promised.
You want to talk to your guards?
I will send you to them. Admitted, Titus. The power of chaos is within you, calling to this relic. Imagine the Ultramarines dominating this galaxy in glorious conquest, with you at their head. Imagine the power you could wield.
As a slave to chaos, nothing you say could tempt me from the path of honor. Or from avenging the deaths of my battle brothers.
I noticed the cannons in his hand. It was disturbing. Because it was like teeth going up it. Ooh. Fires and boat ends. No, I approve of the attempted symmetry. Stopped existing. My God, the powers of chaos. They wanted to save that one Marine. And by Jiminy, they did. Nice. Die already. Get. Nice. wonder if these count towards achievements given their infinite respawning. Probably because, you know, getting fucking killed by them. Not like they're chaff. I assume they're infinite respawning. No, seemingly not. It's just to figure out these guys were active.
Your pathetic Imperial forces will be scoured clean from this world. Soon, my
Might have done that too early.
Fleet will crush into this reality.
I wonder if we'll dare to ever regen. It doesn't seem so, but maybe I just never give it a chance. Maybe on a higher difficulty. Thank you for the health. Oh, be sure to use it to kill your boss. Actually, yeah, it seems that it does.
Your task is hopeless, Titus. I have the will of the Dark Gods behind me. But you have no one. And you will die here, alone. Killing my servants matters little. I am unassailable. The gods of chaos protect me with the very energies of creation.
You forget, Nemeroth. I am no stranger to the touch of the warp.
Okay, despite his size, he's one hell of a lightweight. I was expecting a more of a duel on top than a brawl. Where's the magic he showed before? Like, Nice. Like, Titus is only somewhat resistant to it. That was actually pretty awesome. I was expecting more of a duel, then they go fine off. But still. That was pretty badass.
I see the Ultramarines are human. After all.
More than you know, Lieutenant.
Inquisition is here.
His injuries appear chaos inflicted. You are certain of this charge?
Captain Titus has been corrupted by chaos, Inquisitor Thrax.
I am no heretic!
You lie! Only an agent of chaos could withstand such warp exposure.
I sent the demon to oblivion. But did you have unholy assistance? We must know. You will submit to my authority, Captain, or the Inquisition must conclude that you have corrupted every Ultramarine under your command. Not to mention those who stand at your side.
Ignore his threats. Come on.
The Inquisition will destroy you, Mira. And the Ultramarines will be forever dishonored. Leave my brothers and the Lieutenant alone. I will come with you. I do not know why. Resist the touch of chaos, but I swear I will discover the truth. We will discover many truths, Space Marine.
Codex Astartes leaves no room for doubt. You cannot touch the warp and emerge unscathed.
The Codex Astartes is a set of rules. They guide us, shape us as Ultramarines, teach us to hold duty and honor sacred above all. But how we live with those rules is the true test of a Space Marine. And you have failed.
Armored in glory. Upon their invasion contained, strategic assets secured. Ongoing status. Quarantined by order of Inquisitor Thrax. Recommended course of action. Investigate Ultramarines Captain Titus for heresy, evidence of heresy. Warhammer 40K Space Marine. That was a great game. Memory of Brian Wood. 1977 to 2010. Designer, mentor, father, and friend. We miss you still. Rock Entertainment. So yeah, that was Warhammer 40K Space Marine. A fantastic game. I'm glad I finally got to play it. And I do recommend other people to give it a play, give it a shot. It is tons of fun. It is a great game, and again, I wish I was more of a fan of 40K, because I feel I would have enjoyed it all the more for it, you know? Part of me was thinking while I was playing it, it feels, I don't know. Love letter was the phrase coming to mind, you know? Titus ended up being quite a well-loved character by, you know, 40K fans. And from what little I've been hearing among a small niche, just like one of the few Ultramarine characters people liked. The critique was others were too perfect. They're the best at, you know, things. Or, you know, well, not Matt Ward, blah. This is what I'm hearing. I don't know enough myself to comment one way or another. But he ended up being quite well-loved. Character in general, and then especially among Ultramarines as a whole. Like, they're named characters and the like. Someone mentioned him surfing on a Titan. He didn't really do that. I was kind of expecting him, like, sliding along and trying to, like, fire a gun at the same time kind of thing. The other thing was, Space Marine 2 and 3, they'd already plans for it. Second one was he was going to end up going rogue. Not he wasn't corrupted, but he was, you know, he'd gone rogue. And presumably about him, you know, finding out his resistance to chaos and the like. And then the third one would have been him coming back and founding his own chapter. Presumably a subset of Ultramarines. Presumably. So yeah, sadly, apparently it's not looking likely in the slightest that it will get a sequel. But I really don't say no. Let me see, 40K, Space Marine 2. Seems to be a lot of hope for it, but yeah, no. No plans for it. Apparently a guy did actually ask them and they actually responded to him. But it's a YouTube video, so I can't have a look at it. Apparently Relic does want to make more, but Oh, actually, when I was saying someone asked him about it, I stumbled into the same guy who was actually asking THQ Nordic about it as well. He was just seeing if they had any rights to it or anything like that, but no, it's Sega's the one who holds it. Ah, oh, that's disappointing. Like I was saying, it is a good game, and I would like to see what they had planned for it, you know? And if it, you know, measured up to this, you know, you can see it being a beloved part of the series, a beloved part of 40K, you know? Well, you never know what will come, you know? We can live in hope. Live in hope. So, I'll just let the credits play out. Because I feel, you know, everyone should get, you know. I feel it's only right that they get credit for it, you know? I am going to be a pain in the ass for 1 second. I don't like doing this, but apparently there's a better uploader for YouTube partners. And while I do have access to the community tab on YouTube, which is apparently what you get for being that, I don't have access to anything else as part of being a partner. I was previously, but monetization was then jacked up to a different point, and I have yet to reach it, so I lost access to that. But apparently there was a better uploader for partners. Maybe it's actually higher than I think it is. But basically I was just saying, thinking, if you like this series, hit like, hit subscribe, share it, you know, something. You know, it would help me out. Just simply, by the time this comes out, at the end of this month, the passable uploader on YouTube is going away. Previously, there was no upload limit per tab on YouTube. You could open up the YouTube uploader and put up over 100 videos into it. You could possibly maybe only upload 100 in a day. That's how it is now, but in the past it might have still had that, I have no idea. But you could toss over 100 into the list. I did that once or twice. Not all of them got done. The internet's not nearly fast enough. They weren't nearly small enough. But I had them all in and queued up, and I got like 80 of them done. They eventually capped it at 100, and I was thinking, oh, that's a bit sad, but that's fine. I wasn't going to get over 100 done anyway. Might even get 100 done anyway. But recently, they've nerfed it to 15. I found a way around it in opening multiple tabs. Currently have 3 open right now, uploading, and 4 there done. Just have to look through the videos, make sure I didn't mess anything up, and then I can go about deleting them. But soon that's going away. I'll have to use a new uploader. And the new uploader is just a straight decrease, just a straight downgrade from what's currently there. The new uploader has an inherent load screen at the start of it. The current uploader, you just go straight into it. There might be a little bit of lag as, you know, the video's going in and the like, but as the page is loading, but, you know, it's insignificant. The new uploader, its loading screen is about as long as it takes for the browser to recognize 50 videos you're trying to upload at once. Like, you grab a bunch of 50, hit upload, and it takes a moment for my browser to, you know, process it, you know, my computer process all that. There's a little bit of a lag. That's how it is for each and every video on the new uploader. And that's like a built-in load thing, you know? Maybe I'm botching that. Maybe I'm not phrasing that right. I haven't been well for the last bit. Medical complaint I haven't complained about, one that I haven't. It's distracting me. But that's my story and I'm sticking to it. But yeah, basically, there's that lag at the start of it, that loading screen. Maybe if I had a better rig, maybe if I had faster internet, maybe it goes faster. I have no idea. But for me, it's about the same as an express thanks for spouses, lovers, and significant others. Help us get up and go to work in the morning and made us excited to come home at night. Aww. But, Oh, damn it, my mind's blanking. Yeah, there's the loading time at the start that's slow. And then beyond that, everything isn't just on the one page like it is right now. There's now it's now split between 3 pages. And I just want to say it was a bit slow switching between the 3. I can't remember. I try. I'm trying to forget about it. I want to live, you know, live in oblivious peace till it suddenly, you know, raises its ugly head. But anyway, yeah. Basically, there's that lag. It's not easily condensed and laid out. I frequently scroll back to with the current uploader. I frequently scroll back to the previous videos, making sure I'm scheduling it on the right date. I can't do that anymore. The new video manager doesn't show things in order. You try and tell it, okay, show me things in order of release, and it'll randomly have things at the start of the list that are out of order of release. Or order of upload, or whatever. Randomly have things at the top of the list that are completely wrong. The current video manager shows you everything in order of your upload. The new one doesn't. It'll be generally that way, but it'll have the random one at the start that goes against it. It's the whole system's inferior. You can help me, you know, not rip all my hair out, liking, sharing, subscribing, whatever. Apparently, there's a better uploader if you get it to a certain point. I was initially thinking it was 1,000 subs and 4,000 hours watched in a year. That might just be for monetization and not for the better uploader. I don't know. I can live in hope. That's all I can do. It was on some well-hidden YouTube help page. I can't speak one way or the other to it beyond that. I've heard no one talk about it. So, though at the same time I've heard no one talk about the new uploader. Like, I'm the only one. Well, actually, I heard one other person talk about it, but that was just one of the new things they have on the page. Content warnings or the like. That was it. They didn't acknowledge the fact that you can't upload multiple videos at once anymore. Like, you can toss one up, then work on the next and the next, presumably. But as it is, you can just grab, highlight them all and toss them all up and keep them on the one tab, even if it is in groups of 15. With the new one, you toss one up, you have to deal with it, that one, then you get to work on the next one, the next one, next one, all individually. If you get me. Like, often when I'm working on the videos now, I'll put the tags in for each one, then I'll do the grammatical changes for each one. I'll handle it this way. Then I'll end up scheduling it. I said grammatical changes. At the start of this, in this video's heading, it'll be Warhammer 40k, the two dots, Space Marine. You can't save a video file on your computer with the two dots. There's a few symbols you can't use, like a question mark. So if you ever see a video with a question mark in the title, or it's missing one, that's why. I just forgot to put it in. They put in the symbol. But yeah, those two dots is an example of it, of what you can't use. So I put a semicolon in instead, so I at least see it and remember. So if you ever see a semicolon left over, that's why I forgot. And that's why I've started using the squiggly line instead of the dash, because the squiggly line, you can use it, and it doesn't go away when you upload it to YouTube. Some symbols go away, like the dash. I have to put it back in, but while the squiggly line doesn't, so it saves me that bit of time. It's insignificant, but it saves you a bit of time. So, basically, long story short, it's just like, share, subscribe if you like my content. If you don't, obviously you don't have to. It would still help, if you still want to do charity work, good favor for the decade, I also accept it, but you don't have to. So anyway, I sincerely hope you've enjoyed this. I didn't mean to bomb for so long, but it was just, I ended up going into too much detail. I sincerely hope you've enjoyed this, and I do hope you join me again soon. If there's anything you'd like to tell me, please let me know in the comment section below, but do keep in mind the backlog. Today is the 23rd of March, 2020. Sweet Christ. The 23rd of March, 2020. By the time this comes out, it will be sometime in, like, actually, it might be, like, not a year's time, or just shy. So do please keep that in mind. Excuse me. My mind's whacking. If there's anything you want to say, do keep in mind that there is that delay. Just do keep that in mind. Also, if this video ends up, uploaded to a different website and not YouTube, obviously the YouTube thing doesn't matter. I had some commenting in the description of a video or talked about in the video itself before, talking about some other YouTube service that by the time the video was released was dead. So it's just like, you never know, maybe YouTube will go belly up by the time this video comes out. Hope not. I really don't want to have to manually upload everything to another website, especially like not the ones that are available. As much as YouTube is slitting its wrists and like diving in a lake, it's still somehow better than its competitors. Beyond having a bigger, viewer base, and presumably maybe favored in Google results, given they're owned by the same company. Imagine there's probably a bit of favoritism going on there. Other things don't have automated playlists. They don't generate thumbnails for you. One requires you to seed things to everyone. And you'd have to join circles to get your videos across, and I suppose that builds, you could be like trying to build a community, but it's also, rather than just putting your videos up and leaving it that, I just feel it's kind of thing that would just end up backfiring on me, or not working out for me. And, yeah. So it's like, as much as YouTube is mutilating itself and just ruining everything, you know, it's a perfectly good-looking person deciding to get plastic surgery. And, yeah, it's not going to turn out well. Yeah, somehow despite that, it still comes out looking better than its competitors. So it's such an annoying thing. Excuse me. Pardon me. But yeah, it's such an annoying thing. I'd love for a valid competitor to turn up, but the way I'm hearing it, it's not too likely. It's not too likely. And it also doesn't seem too likely for YouTube to stop shitting the bed. We'll need some big YouTubers to speak out about it, but I think they only upload like a video a day as it is anyway, so it doesn't affect them in the slightest. I remember I was talking with one of my friends, and he knows I do videos. He's turned up in a few of them before. And he was just like saying, oh, you should upload more. PewDiePie does one a day, and it's just like, yeah, I've released like five a day. I remember I had a plan before once for World of Warcraft Legion to try and upload a video an hour, every hour for like 2 weeks. I ended up not going ahead with it because right around the same time I was queuing everything up for it, talk came out about a guy losing his YouTube account for uploading too many videos at one time. And it was just like, suddenly I felt like, you know, I was just like glimpsing the future, you know? Well, as long as my future isn't becoming Dark Side Phil, you know, that's for the best. That's what one claim was going about. He got, about him anyway. Don't know if it's true, but it scared me the hell off. Anyway, I sincerely hope you've enjoyed this, and I do hope you join me again next time. If you'd like to tell me, please let me know, but do keep in mind the backlog. Do keep in mind the time delay. Not saying not to tell me, Anne, just keep that in mind. And I do apologize again for bumming about the other thing. It's just, oh god, I'm not looking forward to it. In a couple of days, the good uploader is going away, and I'm going to have to deal with the trash that is the new one. I'll still upload, I'll still get her done, but I may turn to drinking, and I'm not sure if it'll mix with my... It will turn me to alcohol. It will turn me to the, you know, to devil water. And I'm not sure in the slightest if it mixed with my medication. But fuck it. You know. If I have to, you know, upload videos this new way, I fucking need to be pissed doing it. There's a reason why before I was saying I'll pay someone 20 quid an hour if I ever made it rich to upload videos for me. There was a reason I said that. And it's just, now I feel I need to pay them a 50 an hour for it. If I have to operate under this new thing. Obviously, I wouldn't have that kind of finances. You know, if I ever made it rich and I was uploading videos, you know, I'll just throw cash at someone to upload them for me. But it just makes me double down on that feeling. But anyway, I sincerely hope you've enjoyed this, and I do hope you join me again soon. If there's anything at all you'd like to tell me, please let me know in the comment section below. But until next time, love and peace, baby. For the Emperor.